Hello everybody and welcome to a new Azure vlog. I hope you're all doing well, I do at least. In this Azure vlog I want to talk about Azure Sentinel, which is a really cool new product of Microsoft. In the on-premise world we have a SIEM and we have to do capacity planning for it. We need to make sure that the hardware is maintained, etc. We now have such a service in Azure and that's called Azure Sentinel. It's a SIEM built in the cloud. We can scale it quite easy. There is AI in it. It has connections with the Azure AD, Office 365, etc. In this Azure vlog, I want to show you how you can set up Azure Sentinel and connect it to your Azure Active Directory. So, without further ado, let's dive into the technical stuff. All right, so in order to get you started, you need to have an Azure subscription. If you have that subscription, follow my instructions. Within the Azure portal, search for Sentinel. You will see Azure Sentinel Preview. That's where you can configure your Azure Sentinel services. In order to have Azure Sentinel working, you need to have a Log Analytics workspace. Log Analytics functions as some kind of data store for all your logs, which is used by Sentinel. So let's add our workspace, create a new workspace. Let's call this Azure Vlog Demo Workspace. Azure Vlog Demo. We use as resource group name and we put it in West Europe. Okay, so Azure is now deploying the Log Analytic workspace. Once that's complete, we can connect it to Azure Sentinel. How this actually works is that we have a Log Analytics workspace that stores our data, and around that we have a layer that's called Azure Sentinel with all the SIEM logic that you can use. Okay, the Log Analytics workspace is ready now. We can add Azure Sentinel to that workspace. Okay, the workspace in Azure Sentinel is ready now. We have a couple of things over here. We have the overview, which gives us a status of what's happening in Azure Sentinel, where the alerts are coming from, etc. We have logs, which actually access our Log Analytics workspace. We can put all kinds of queries over here. We have dashboards. As you will see in a couple of minutes, when we deploy a connection, for example, to the Azure Active Directory, we can also deploy some dashboards with that. There is a hunting tab, which can be used for threat hunting. Really amazing, quite a cool feature. I'll do a separate vlog on that. We have a tab for notebooks where we can run Jupyter notebooks, for example. But first, let's connect our Azure AD tenant. And that's quite easy. If we go to data connectors and we go to Azure Active Directory, we click configure. You'll see that when I connect the Azure AD, we now have the sign-in logs. That's also connected for the audit log, so we can see what's changed in the directory. We can also install the sign-in logs dashboard. Let's click on install to that one. This is what a dashboard will look like, and as you see, there is no data in it. Not all connectors directly inject their data into Azure Sentinel. There might be a slight delay in there. In the case of the Azure Directory, there is a slight delay. So let's wait a couple of minutes until there is data, and I will show you how you can use these dashboards, what they will display to you, and how you can use the Azure Data Explorer in order to do some investigation yourself. I'll get back to you once there is data in my Azure Sentinel workspace. So we are 5 minutes in the future right now. I added a user, I logged into that with that user, I made sure that conditional access, MFA, is applied to that user. So there should be some event logs in our Sentinel workspace right now. So let's go to our Sentinel workspace. Let's click on the workspace. We see over here that there are 6 audit logs and 5 sign-in logs. Well, let's see if the data is in our dashboard. If we go to, for example, the Azure AD audit logs, there should be something in there because I created a user and I updated it with our MFA configuration. So let's click on that. And yes, there is data. There are 6 user management entries. We can see that the user has updated twice. There is a user edit, etc. So this is quite a nice and handy dashboard to see what's happening in your Azure Active Directory. And remember, this is only the connector for the Azure AD. If we go to our Sentinel workspace and go to data connectors, you'll see that there is much more. We can integrate this SIEM solution with Office 365, Advanced Threat Protection, Azure Security Center, and even third-party connectors are available. For example, F5, or Fortinet, or Checkpoint. Those guys are delivering awesome web application firewalls, etc., to the Azure platform. We can monitor them also with Azure Sentinel. Quite handy. Now let's go to logs, because if there is something, you might want to do an investigation. And this is where you can start. This is where you can do your querying. And it makes use of the query language of Log Analytics. That's called Gusto. I will put a link in the description of this video to awesome pages where they explain how you can learn Gusto, and there's even a good Pluralsight course. We'll also show that one in the description below of this video. But first, let's see what actually can be queried over here. So over here, for example, sign-in logs. Let's limit our result to 50. We'll see every attempt of sign-in activity that has been executed on our Azure Active Directory. And we see that a user has not passed the MFA challenge a couple of times. We can even see which user it is. Well, it's actually myself. So this is quite handy. And these queries also form the basics of hunting. If you expect something or there is a new threat in the world, you can hunt for this in your workspace. You can see if it has already been executed in your environment, or you can check if your environment is vulnerable for that threat. And that can be done by doing hunting. And if we go to, for example, Azure AD sign-ins from new locations, we can see the query over here that's used for that hunting. Well, what we see over here is that Netherlands is a new country. And this is actually the query that is used to detect if we have logins from new locations. And this query is used for that. It's quite an interesting query. You can have a look at it yourself, because these queries come with Azure Sentinel. You get them for free with your workspace. And I will do a separate Azure vlog on them. So we'll go in depth on threat hunting. And I'll make sure that there are some threats in my environment, so we have some nice results. At this moment, everything is good and well, so we don't have alerts. So, and that's how you can get started with Azure Sentinel. It's not that hard. In a future vlog, I will talk about threat hunting, and I will also talk about alerting, because it's good to have all this data over here. It's amazing to have those dashboards, but we as administrators want to get alerted when something extraordinary is happening in our environment. We want to get notice of that. That I will tell you in a next Azure vlog. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. You can contact me by Twitter or just reacting on this video. It's all good for me. And yeah, with that, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.